Hello, everybody. Hello, my name is Paul. Welcome, one and all. Wow. So this chapter, really heavy on the story and the character development, kind of light on the puzzles and the action and everything. But that's actually, no, not really light on puzzles. Just not as action-packed, I guess, as the last ones were. So this one's great. I love what's happening here. So we have the two potential Valanices. There's the fun-loving niece, and then the little bit more serious and more contrasting to Graham's personality, V, or a Val, or I think it was, I forget, one of the two, the black-haired one, the raven-haired beauty. Anyway, so it looks like we really hit it off, and she's going to be the one. She's going to be our Valanice, but nothing's over yet. We don't know. So they're both in bed. It doesn't look like we're in love, quote-unquote, in love enough to leave the tower. And even if we did leave the tower, I wonder what we can do. Like, can we get Niece out? Can we help Hagatha? She's become kind of a sympathetic character. I don't know. Anyway, so it looks like while everyone's asleep, there's not too much we can do. So we will... Where's Hagatha? Wait. I know exactly what we can do. So I figure we would go back and we can use a few more of these portraits to go wherever. But Whisper came up and he gave us the Minute Hand. And then that awkward love poem. I'm curious about what I would do with this. And then Hagatha's book. And we're going to set the clock to 5:40 and see what happens. Can I read the book? No. And 5:40 it shall be. Oh, 5:40. No, that is 5:40. That do anything? Well, I guess hitting the button is just the reset button. I'll just leave it on 5:40 and I guess we'll see what happens. Whatevs, not fussed at the mo.
A knock. From the inside.
Uh-oh.
Has a pretty princess joined me all the way down here?
I have.
Have you brought a gift? Quote, princesses must always bring a gift to those they visit, unquote.
Right, a gift. Let me get right on that.
How about a poem? Would you like a poem? I have one of those.
Now's not the time for that.
Dang. Can I give her her book? Oh, maybe I can get her to sign it.
What do you think about this gift?
I'm sorry. It's not a very personal gift.
All right. Gifties. Gifties. Need a gift in order to get access to... the room. I don't know what else I could bring her. It reset. Interesting. Maybe if I just turn it this way instead. The only thing I can think of to do is, I have the picture of the clock, so let's see if we can look back in time for a different combination. I'm grasping at straws. All right, so there it is at 5:40. And now it's at, was that? Nah, 10:20. What does, I don't quite understand why it wants that time now instead, but okay. Whatever. Oh, look at this. Okay. Oh, wow.
She ran off to get away from them, didn't she?
Oh, that's her parents. Oh.
She did. Hagatha's parents did not treat her the way a princess should be treated. They saw her powers as a threat to their kingdom, so they locked her away in a tower and threw away the key.
Wow.
So, all she really wanted was a family?
We had that in common.
Oh, poor Hagatha. I really do like a sympathetic villain, even though she is technically a villain at this point. But, what did I grab? Would this be a gift she wants? Hagatha's box of memories, yes. Extremely personal. She'll probably be a little bit curious about where I got it from, but doesn't matter. It is the key to progression.
I picked this out special for you.
Oh. My. I'm sorry. This looks like a wonderful gift, but it's not.
Hagatha, you can stop the charade. I know.
You know what, beautiful?
I know all about who you are and why we're here.
Do you like tea? Perhaps you should come inside.
Oh, we're gonna learn a little bit more about her past.
Inside. Inside is the problem. You've locked us all away inside. You've... What do you have cooking in here?
Oh, that! That's nothing. Pay that
you
no
know
mind.
Exactly what that is.
Listen, there's a giant world out there, and it may not be safe, and it may not be perfect, but it's real. And it's about time you experienced it.
Oh, I'm locked away by the power of this tower too, Princess. No one ever loved me enough to save me from its enchantment.
That's nonsense. You don't need anyone else. I can't believe I'm going to quote Whisper, but you need to...
love yourself. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Remember Lug Day? It is totally love yourself.
Love yourself. You don't need anyone to rescue you. You can escape this tower by yourself.
Oh, I'm not ready.
Oh, this reminds me of the plot to Hairspray. Now, if this turns into a gigantic 50s musical, I'm all over it.
Go on. It's time.
Welcome to the 60s!
Some words of encouragement would help.
Yes.
Okay, that's all I have. It's got a picture of cheese on it. That's a lovely.
Oh. I've never heard kinder, sweeter words spoken about me. Well, I have to be careful not cry as my skin will dry out. You are indeed a good princess.
Oh, Hagatha.
Do you want to step outside?
I really hope this breaks your spell.
Might.
Hagatha was, like, in the original games, just an awful, horrid witch. But now... oh, no!
Sarge! I guess I'm not quite ready to leave yet. I should...
Let's do it together.
What?
Princess Hagatha, would you take
this
my
is
hand?
Amazing. I this makes me so happy. Come on, Hagatha. Let's go. You and me. I love you. There she goes.
Thanks, Princess Grey.
Oh, she knew who I was.
Should I say King Graham? You brought back a young soul to a very old woman.
Oh, uh-oh. Oh, shoot.
The Frost Tonic.
Oh, no.
The what?
Oh. It's happening. I got it. Oh, dear.
The princesses. They're still trapped inside.
This is bad. Okay. Niece and Val, don't worry. We've got this. I've got to climb all the way back up again.
Okay. Yeah. Take my adventuring rope.
Oh, you had one the whole time. Oh, that's handy. Why don't I have one of those? All right, Graham, no time to waste. Go. All right, this is particularly tricky because I need to hold up. And I just need to hold up as hard as I can. Ugh. That's right, still holding up. Okay, now, all right, now with the interactive portion. Here we go. Faster, faster, faster. Come on, come on, come on, come on. See, this is a tower rescue. This is how it's to be done. There we go. Up again. I really hope I'm setting save points. Now, the question is, if she knew I was a King Graham, I guess she was just deluding herself. So she knew I wasn't a princess. Unless maybe after she stepped out of the tower, she knew what was going on, or I don't know. I really think she was just sort of too far gone. Oh, epic version of Girl in the Tower playing. All right, there we go. I've caught up now. We're doing fine. Come
You're
on.
Both going to have to jump!
The spell is unbroken!
Come on. Don't go into that good night.
Me! Watch out!
Oh. Did you just slice her hand?
Worked? It worked!
Come on! Oh no, come on, I'm not gonna leave him behind.
Wait, Nace!
Come on, pull her in. Do it. Come on. Don't let her die. Please don't die. You can do it. Oh. No. Oh, Nace. I'm coming back for you. You'll be fine. You'll just be frozen. You're not dead. You'll be okay. That's right. Come on, V. If you're going to be the true queen of Daventry, do it. That's all it took? She could have done that. Good. There we go. Sisterhood. Bring it on. See, you guys could have escaped this tower at any time because you guys loved each other. Power of friendship, y'all. Oh, there it is. Me and V, BFFs. And he survived.
It's Valenice. My full name is Princess Valenice of Eastern Klima.
Aha. So I wonder if we ever learned what Nisa's full name was. Oh, look, she approves. Oh, but also a little sad. Oh, whoa. Is it spreading or is she okay?
And then, you and Grandma V lived happily ever after.
Well, we got to know each other a little better before I proposed again.
Good call.
Lucky for me, I got a yes on the second time. And we've lived happily most of the time. A loving marriage is worth all the hard work that goes into it. And that's no fairy tale.
Oh, Hagatha. Oh, she's smiling. Hey. Is she going to be okay? I'm really concerned about Nice, though. I really hope, like, her ice hand doesn't turn into some sort of, you know, she just gets bitter and she turns into some kind of villain later. Or if it does kind of spread, kind of frozen style. But no matter, choco chip pancakes, Valenice's birthday, or V.
All right, you can come in now.
And we finally get to see Valenice in present day. They'll finally show her face because we know the previous version. There she is.
Oh, it smells delightful in here.
Our table is ready, dear.
You know, I've always loved this restaurant.
Happy birthday, V.
You rigged the magic bowl to bake breakfast?
We still have that? We still
Well, aren't you the hotcake?
I was waffling with it for a while before I got the pancakes to taste.
Is that the same bowl from King's Quest 1? Did we keep it? Did we steal it back from the lumberjacks or the woodcutter?
Toast.
Sometimes you just have to keep trying until you pancake it anymore.
Oh, God.
I have never been more in love with you than I am in this very moment. Aha, Gwendolyn must be ready with her surprise. Come in, sweetheart.
I can only imagine how this must be to a person who, like, isn't married or has children. If, I'm not sure if it hits them as hard, but I am just grinning ear to ear right now.
Oh, my. You made this?
Sure did.
It looks like the box that, Yeah, it's the puzzle box that you used to smash the glass that saved Nice.
How did you know?
A little birdie told me.
We never did fix that puzzle box.
Well, I just love it. And I can't wait to tinker with it. This one looks like just the right amount of tricky. The way I like them. Thank you, Gwendolyn.
The real present is what's inside that puzzle box.
Is it another heart?
Let's solve it together.
Aw, do it. Is there one more puzzle before we go? Do I get to interact
you
with this?
Turn that.
I'll twist this.
And that should do it.
It's not much of a puzzle box. Oh, look at that. It's the hourglass that brought us together. Well, an hourglass. A symbolic hourglass. That means Gwendolyn built this present after she heard the story about me, V, and the hourglass. That's fast work.
Oh. Oh, dear. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything, Grandma. Just listen.
This is my favorite birthday ever.
I am legit going to cry. Oh, Morden. Morden, what are you up to? Are you planning a rebellion against your brother? Oh.
Well, how do I look?
Oh my god, he got his new body.
Very old.
Yes. Alright, so that was it. So that proved... Alright, so... Oh god, alright. Let's recap everything that just happened here. Alright, so we met Mordak for the very first time. Well, not for the very first time. Now, let's go way back. Alright. Mordak. He was the goblin who was raised as a practical joke. The human being that was raised as a practical joke by the goblins. Our kindness, King Graham's kindness, rescued him from that predicament. And then Manny picked him up. So Manny and Mordak are basically kind of as tight as brothers right now. But that would mean that Mordak kind of... At some point, when we relive the events or get past the events of King's Quest V, might remember who I was and the kindness that sort of helped set him free from his punishment or whatever. So maybe that'll kind of alter what happens at that point. And then Manny took the transformation potion and turned himself into a very old man, which is exactly how he looked in King's Quest III. Now, that kind of makes sense. Because in the events of King's Quest V, Mordak pretty much looks exactly the same way he does now. Kind of youngish, muscular. And then in King's Quest III, Manny was this old, wizened, bearded guy. Yeah, I never really thought about that. Manano looked so much older and Mordak looked younger, and yet still they were brothers. So I just figured, I don't know, maybe their parents, you know, can still get it on at a ripe old age. But this sort of pays a little bit of attention to that. So let's see what we have down here in the finals. So we got, so we got the blanket. So this represents, we can go visit any of the three people from the teleporter. And I decided to visit who I thought was the Cobblepots, but it's actually Acorn. He gave us this cool blanket, which we in turn gave not to V, but to Nice for whatever reason. But we still ended up winning V's heart. And that was really, really adorable. That was really the ticket. And this would change depending on who we ended up marrying, V or Nice. So this would be an acorn, most likely, if we married Nice in the end. And then whoever we didn't marry gets the icy hand, which seems like kind of a raw deal. But I'm sure this will play out in the later on. But I really hope whoever it was doesn't turn into like some kind of a villain. That would be really sad. And that was it. That was Once Upon a Climb. Sorry for kind of the short part. I had no idea how long this part would act. Well, the chapter would actually be. But I had to sit back down again and play this like right away. I was really emotionally invested in this part. So brilliant writing. Really tugs at the heartstrings there. Now the only downside is that we have to wait for another couple of months for Chapter 4 to come out. And I think there is only a total of five chapters. Which means this might be coming to an end, which really makes me sad. But we'll just have to wait. I'm sure there's a plan of some sort happening in the end. Oh, so Mananin and Mordak are back in the picture. Queen Valenice, we've solved that little bit of a mystery. Gart is turning into a little bit of a dick. Our favorite grandchild, Gwendolyn, of course. Not that we can call her our favorite, but she's totally our favorite. With that being said, that is the end of Chapter 3. I totally encourage all of you, if you have not already, go over to Steam and get yourself, or the PlayStation Network or whatever, and go ahead and grab the first three chapters of King's Quest. They always go on sale. You can usually get them for super cheap. Play the original games if you haven't. You can go back into my YouTube channel and go pick out some of the older King's Quest games if you want to check them out. King's Quest V, especially, which is one of my personal favorites. King's Quest VI is probably the best. And I'm not getting into that conversation right now. Anyway, that was it. And I am going to go grab a snack. So I leave you with, as always, good night, Jelly Beans. Good night.
Watch out! A
poisonous
snake!
Actually, snakes are venomous, Gwendolyn. But that's beside the point. The baby owl did not meet its end that day.